With energy prices rising, solar isn't just about going green. It's about keeping more money in your pocket. But here's what most people don't realize. The cost of solar isn't just about the panels, labor, equipment, a roof mount versus a ground mount, and even where you live, all play a role. In this video, we're breaking it all down. We go over the factors that impact solar installation costs, provide real numbers on what you can expect to pay, and review the main incentives available to help you reduce the cost. Walk us through what factors will impact the installation costs and how.
Yeah, there's a couple of things to keep in mind here, Warren. One is the installation type and location. So installation type meaning, is it a ground mount? Is it a roof mount? A ground mount, you know, you might be more expensive on the racking side. A roof mount, you know, if it's several stories high, you know, it's going to take time and effort to get that the conduit set up and those kinds of things. And then, of course, the location of the solar array. Is it right next to the meter where we can just connect right in, or do we have to go several hundred feet before we can connect into the meter? So that's something to keep in mind, installation type and location. The type of the roof, if it's a roof mount, is it a shingle roof? Is it a metal roof? Is it standing seam? That's going to affect your cost a bit. The type of the equipment used. So is it a string inverter? Is it a microinverter? Is it an inverter optimizer solution? Do you have a special panel in mind, you know, all black panel that you want with a special look, a special type? So that's a factor. The system size, of course.
Right.
The more panels you add, the more expensive it's going to be.
Sure.
But then the lower it's going to be cost per panel.
Right.
Typically. The amount of shade in the local weather is going to affect your system size.
Right.
That doesn't necessarily affect the price, but it will affect how much your system produces, which affects your system size, which affects your cost. Interconnection costs is a factor, especially for commercial projects. So for some systems, there's additional equipment that the utility requires us to install. Or in some extreme cases, the utility might require some of their system to be upgraded to accommodate the install. Utility equipment upgrades, your transformer, your service equipment that you have on site at your location that's owned by the utility might need to be upgraded. And then also permitting. And again, this isn't going to be much of a factor for residential typically.
Yep.
Once you get into commercial, especially larger commercial, permitting costs can become more of a factor.
Now that we know what goes into the installation costs, let's provide some real numbers. What can the average homeowner expect to pay for a solar installation in 2025?
When we talk about system costs, we're talking about a price per watt. That's
correct.
What the industry talks about. Typically for residential, we're talking about $2 to $3 per watt, or maybe even up to $3.50 or $4 a watt, depending on some of those factors that we just talked about. So if we have a 5 kW system and we use $3 a watt, now, let me just the caveat here, that's a pretty small system.
Right.
So you're probably getting more than $3 a watt. Let's use $5 a watt just to kind of give us a better, maybe a better idea. That's $25,000. There you're talking about $60 a month in savings, about $25,000 upfront cost. A 10 kW system, now we're maybe getting closer to that, you know, $3.50 or $3 a watt. Let's say $30,000 for $120 a month savings.
Right.
So you see how we doubled in size and went from $25,000 to $30,000. It's probably not going to be that significant of a difference in price per watt. But, you know, just by doubling in size, we really lowered our price per watt there.
Right. Seems like there's a lot of fixed costs going into that small system.
There are. Yep, that 5 kW is going to be challenging to get that a really good price per watt. And then, of course, if we're looking at ground mounts or any other additional cost for trenching and such, that's going to be additional.
And so what would some real costs look like for a business?
So for commercial, typically there's bigger projects. So we have the economies of scale that we just talked about.
Right.
Meaning a lower cost per watt. But the total investment then is much larger.
Sure.
Because now you have a bigger system. So now we're talking about costs between maybe $1.50, $1.75 on the really low end, up to maybe $2.50 or even $3 a watt on the high end, depending on some of those factors we talked about. So let's think about a 50 kW, and let's think about $2.50 a watt.
Right.
So you know we're talking about $125,000. That's about the right range for 50 kW, $600 a month in savings. If we go up to 100 kW, maybe we can think about $2 a watt. So now we're talking about $200,000. That's kind of the right range that we're looking at.
And also with commercials, there's additional incentives that you don't get with residential. So that helps bring down that price per watt as well. Some viewers might feel a bit of sticker shock mm-hmm. after hearing those numbers. And that's completely understandable. But here's the good news. Long-term energy savings and these valuable incentives can significantly improve the return of your solar investment. What are some of the key incentives that help offset those costs?
Yes, I want our customers to first of all understand that solar is a cost reduction tool.
Right.
It's going to lower your costs in the long term. That's the key. That's the most important piece. These other incentives can help offset the installation cost. For homeowners, for example, the federal tax credit is available, covers 30% of the total system cost.
Right.
That's the basic incentive for homeowners. There may be some other smaller incentives based on your utility, your county, your state, some of those types of things. The basic incentive is going to be that 30% tax credit. Commercial projects can have more incentives. So there's a couple of things. You have that same tax credit at 30%.
Right.
There are opportunity for some adders to that tax credit. So depending where your system is based and depending on what equipment you use, if you use enough equipment that's made in the U.S., you can potentially get a 40% or even a 50% tax credit.
Right.
And I want to just stress here that these tax credits are upfront. So as long as you have the tax liability, you can take advantage of these tax incentives immediately. You don't have to wait. It doesn't have to stretch out over 30 years. You can take advantage of it right away.
Well, they're upfront in terms of you can use them in year one.
Correct.
But they're not upfront in terms of paying for your solar system.
Yep, that's correct. So it's not cash that you get.
Correct.
It's a tax credit against your tax liability. So it does depend on how much tax liability you have.
Right.
So that's the investment tax credit. And then the other piece for businesses is the bonus depreciation, which essentially lowers your tax liability even farther, because you're able to depreciate that project over a six-year period rather than stretching out for a longer period like you'd have to do for some other investments.
Are you thinking about investing in solar in 2025? We'd love to hear from you. Drop a comment below and let us know what's your biggest question or concern about investing in solar. And don't forget to check out our free solar ROI calculator linked in the description below. In just a few clicks, you'll get an estimate of how solar could benefit your family or business. For those in the Mid-Atlantic region looking for exact numbers, our team of solar consultants are here to help. Click the link below to request your free custom quote to see exactly how solar could benefit you.